If you've been working with the 3D renderer in Godot, you've probably come across the grid map at some point. It can be a great way to optimize performance by reducing draw calls and speed up level prototyping. But it's currently a bug that is causing some nasty visual problems that look similar to Zed fighting. If you look closely, you'll notice as I move this purple node along the grid map, there's a lot of flickering on the seams as we move along the Zed axis. Even in the editor, we can see lots of black dots appearing on the seams too. The bug is currently being tracked on GitHub, but in the meantime, there are two solutions that I have found that can reduce this or eliminate it completely. The way you would typically combat Zed fighting is to reduce the near and far culling boundaries of your camera to improve the floating point accuracy, or move your overlapping geometry slightly further apart. However, since this isn't Zed fighting in the typical sense, these options will not work. As you can see here, I have the culling boundaries set pretty close together, but the issue still persists. The quickest method is to set the MSAA anti-aliasing option to 4 and also enable TAA. This is not the most ideal solution, as if your project has no need for these options, it will reduce performance. And as the TAA implementation in Godot is not fully complete, it may introduce ghosting artifacts while in motion. However, this will improve things with relatively low effort. As you can see, when moving the purple node with these anti-aliasing options enabled, the flickering is barely visible. However, if you look closely, it will be possible to see it, and it will be more noticeable for textured materials. The slower method of fixing this, which will eliminate the issue completely, is going to take a lot more effort depending on how far along your project is. The cause of the flickering is the internal faces of the cubes in the grid map sharing the same space on the Z-axis. So what we need to do to resolve this is remove that internal geometry that we can't actually see. This is the scene that I've created containing my source meshes for the GridMap mesh library. Here I have my centerpiece, which contains the top and bottom faces. This is the side piece that contains the top, bottom and side faces. And lastly, I have a corner piece which contains two side faces, as well as the top and bottom faces. By using these three pieces, I can now create the same geometry in the grid map as I had before, but with a completely hollow inside that doesn't contain any faces sharing the same space on the Z-axis. Now you can see when moving the purple node with the hollowed out meshes, there is no flickering at all, and there is no need for the performance overhead of the anti-aliasing options used in the first solution. For most level designs, you'll probably need more than 3 meshes and instead need 9, in a similar way that you'd create a 9 patch file when working with 2D tile sets. If your project is using plain coloured cubes, however, just using these 3 meshes and rotating them accordingly will work fine. I'll leave links to the relevant GitHub issues in the description in case you want to keep track of this yourself, but in the meantime, I hope this helps.